It's safe to say field watches are my favorite type of watch. There's just something about the dial layout and the ease of use that really appeal to me. And when it comes to affordable field watches, Seiko pretty much has it locked down with their SNK and SNZG field watches. And while they are great, some people think the SNK at 37mm is a little too small. And some people think the SNZG at 42mm is a little too big. So it'd be nice to find something in the middle, say 40mm. And at the same time, if you wanted to upgrade from one of those Seikos to something else, the only obvious choice is a Hamilton, and there's a pretty big price gap between the two. So it'd be nice to find something in the middle there as well. So I gave myself a quest to not only find a good 40mm field watch, but something that price-wise was between Seiko and Hamilton. Something that would be a good alternative to recommend to others. Now, about a month ago on Massdrop, this Victorinox appeared. It was 40mm, Swiss-made, sapphire crystal, high-beat ETA movement, all for 200 bucks. I thought that my quest could be at an end, but there was one small catch. When you think about Swiss watches, Victorinox is not a company that immediately comes to mind, but maybe it should be. For a lot of us, the company holds a special place in our hearts, as it was usually the first pocket watch we got as a kid. As I've gotten older, I've moved on to Leatherman multi-tools, but that logo has always held a special place. And you can clearly see it on the dial of the Victorinox Classic Officer's Watch. But before we go too far, let's do something a little different and talk about its rubber strap. It's a hard rubber strap that's definitely high quality. In fact, it's the only rubber strap I've seen that says it's Swiss made. It has a nice texture and a good signed buckle. Although I do think the buckle and its needle are maybe a little too wimpy for the size of the watch. But I do appreciate and love how it's molded to meet the case. But its biggest drawback by far is that it is one of the hardest rubber straps I've seen. So there will be a bit of a break-in period. But more to the point, it's so hard that it's almost impossible to lay the watch flat on a table for filming. So I just wanted to point it out early on that this is the strap it comes with, because a lot of the footage you will see, it won't have it on. And also, the clearance between the spring bars and the case is really rather tight. So you will have some issues if you're trying to use a thicker strap or a thicker NATO. For a lot of people, I think this watch fits the sweet spot in terms of size for a modern-day field watch. It's 40mm wide, but 43mm with the crown. Lug-to-lug is only 48, and it's fairly thin for an auto at 10.5mm. It uses 20mm straps and weighs a respectable 85 grams, which is pretty much all watch, as those straps are rather light. The case is rather simple, and mostly has this brushed satin finish, except for the clean bezel that surrounds the crystal, as well as its crown, which is also signed with the Victorinox shield. The finishing is excellent, and the only unusual thing is a little bit of a cutout in the case for the straps to be inserted in. But with other straps, they're barely noticeable. The dial has a simple yet reflective black finishing. Overall, the dial's a little busy, but since it's a field watch, it is very effective. The hour indicators are applied Arabic numerals with a little bit of a silver texture. They aren't very tall, but neither is the watch. I think they are just the right height to be noticed. At the top of the dial, the 12 has been replaced with the Victorinox shield. Personally, I like this added touch, but I can see how some might be bothered by not having the traditional 12. The 6 is also replaced with an open date window. It's framed in a matching silver, which is a very nice touch. The hands are sword-shaped in that same matching matte finished silver, but with white loom down the middle. Although breaking from the design is the second hand, which is completely white. It's a very nice touch, as it gives a very stark contrast to the rest of the dial as it circles around. The rest of the dial is painted on, which includes the raised chapter ring with minute indicators, as well as a matching 24-hour indicators on an inner ring, and the ever-important Swiss-made logo on the bottom. Overall, I like the dial design. With the silver indicators and the shield, it's different enough to stand out from a crowd, but not too different. The crystals are sapphire, and I believe it has anti-reflective coating, because at certain angles, that black dial has a little bit of a blue hue. The movement is an ETA 2824, which means you'll get a 38-hour power reserve, as well as hacking and hand winding. You'll also get a very smooth sweeping second hand, as it runs around the dial at 28,800 beats per hour. And it's a little thing, but it's always nice to have a date adjust that is snappy and instantaneous as it hits midnight. With regards to accuracy, I was gaining about 8.5 seconds a day, which is pretty good for a watch at this price. Now, this is an odd thing to say, but I really like its case back. It's hard to explain, but it just feels perfectly at place on this watch. It has the same satin finish, a really nice size that takes up most of the case, as well as a very nice large crystal as well. And it's within that crystal that you can notice the custom rotor of the watch. Overall, the finishing on the movement looks well done. But it's nothing fancy, just a very useful, utilitarian tool look. Except for the small red Victorinox shield on the rotor. It's just big enough to remind you that this watch is something special. Overall, the entire design is well done. It has a small amount of elegance, but at its heart, it's a watch that knows it's a functional tool. It has a beautiful looking dial, but you still get the sense that this watch can go anywhere you need it to and take whatever punishment it has to, which is aided by its 100 meters of water resistance. If there's one disappointment, it's the lume. It's not bad, it's actually quite decent. I was just hoping for better, but it is very usable, just not exceptionally bright. Although if I could make one improvement, it would be to add some lume to the indices, or at the very least, I would have loved to see some lume on the center cross of the Victorinox shield. As for how it wears, pretty good. It hugs your wrist without being too demanding, and it's thin enough that you should be able to wear it with anything. And weight-wise, it's a pretty good balance. My only real complaint is the straps. They're good, but they'll just take a while to break in. So in short, it's a great watch if you can find one. It really seems to hit that sweet spot in size and price. But if it's so great, you might be asking, what's the problem? In short, it's been discontinued and they're no longer in production. And it's pretty hard to recommend a watch that no one can actually find. In fact, it hasn't really been made for a while. I contacted Victorinox to ask them why it wasn't on their website, and they replied back that it was only made for 3 years, from 2009 to 2012. So they haven't made this thing for a good 6 years. So my best guess is that someone was clearing out a warehouse somewhere and just happened to find a big box of these, and they sent them off to Massdrop to be sold. Evidently, Victorinox had a few different versions of the Officer Watch at that time, but it seems like all of them are discontinued. Which really is a pity, but I guess they weren't selling. Which also means that that $200 is a clearance price. Although I have seen some for sale on Amazon for $250. But if I had to guess, I'd say its original MSRP was probably closer to $950, which is what this current watch is going for. But while Victorinox has some nice automatics listed, they currently have nothing at 40mm. Now, it really is a pity that they stopped making these. It really seems to hit the sweet spot on what could be a perfect field watch, not to mention a great alternative to Hamilton. But I guess it really wasn't meant to be, and my quest to find a good alternative continues. Although I am left with one lingering question. Is it okay to wear a Victorinox while you walk around with a Leatherman? Seems kind of wrong to me, but while I ponder that, let me know in the comments what you think about it, as well as if you have any good 40mm field watches that I should take a look at. And as always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for joining me, and I hope to see you next time.